I'll be talking about this evening's compositions. I'll tell you a little bit about how I did them, why I did them, how I got to be here. But right now, let's just start with some music. It's been 15 months of misery. This is the national anthem of the last 15 months. We're not going to take it. Nashville, let's party. Duke Ellington, more than anyone else, turned jazz into a composer's art and also into a concert music. Mood Indigo, one of his most beautiful tunes, had lyrics fitted to it so that it could have a reincarnation as a popular song. That's normal in the history of jazz. That happened with a number of other Ellington tunes, such as the one later in the program, It Don't Mean a Thing. What I've done here is I've tried to arrange this resembling Ellington's original 1930 orchestration as closely as possible. And what I did in particular is in the very last chorus, I'll let you know when I get to that, I'll put a finger up. When I get to the very last chorus, I'm going to recreate Ellington's original orchestration of two muted trombones against one bass clarinet. Now in the 1930s, no other jazz musician would have thought of that. So at the very last chorus, I'm going to play the two muted trombones on the great manual. I'm going to thumb down and play the bass clarinet on the choir manual. I'm going to be accompanying myself on the swell, playing the bass part with my left foot and the expression pedals with my right foot. You know, if playing the organ were easy, it would be called the piano. You can see by my biography, I'm a pretty typical DMA, FAGO, church jobs for 45 years, university job. I don't even know how many publications I have, 70 or 80, something like that. But one of the things that interests me is to find things that organ repertory doesn't present. Well, obviously, you know, there's not a lot of Twisted Sister arrangements out there, so I had to create one. But one thing about the organ is ragtime and early piano jazz almost completely bypassed the pipe organ. There's extremely little of it. So I thought, well, I love ragtime, and two of my most revered teachers, William Albright and William Bolcom, adored ragtime, so let's give it a try. So this is one of only two pieces on today's program that is not an arrangement. This is an original organ composition. I have some organ duos that are also in the style of ragtime and early keyboard jazz. There's a Max Cat Rag and a Charlie Dog Blues. But this is an original composition for organ. It's trying to fill a little gap in organ repertory. When the Nashville chapter asked if I would be willing to do a program, they asked me, what would you be interested in presenting? And I told them there are several things that I do, but I said, take a look at my YouTube channel and look at some of my arrangements of jazz and rock standards and tell me what you think about that. Because frankly, nobody's doing this. I mean, why not? Why not just have some fun? And that's what we're doing. We're having some fun. Nibs and Nobs are the names of Nibber and Nobber, who were a pair of ribbon snakes owned by my wife and daughter. We like pets in my household. So you can see the other piece on the selection is Kayapup Strut, also named after a pet of ours. Original organ composition, Nibs and Nobs. In the style of a Scott Joplin rag from about 1905. Excuse me. I'm from Florida, but I've lived up north for so long that even in an air-conditioned room in the South, it gets a little warm for me, so forgive me. These next three I'm going to play back-to-back. You're welcome to applaud, but I'll go ahead and be setting up for the next piece in each case. The transcription for organ is something that goes back at least 300 years. J.S. Bach transcribed violin concertos by both Vivaldi and Johann Ernst. Of Bach's six Schubler chorales, they're all, in fact, transcriptions from Bach cantatas. The six trio sonatas of Bach, each one has at least one movement that's a transcription from a Bach cantata. The famous Wagner and Mendelssohn wedding marches are, in fact, transcriptions. If you play an accompaniment for the Hallelujah chorus on the organ, you are, in fact, playing a transcription. And popular songs have been in use in keyboard music for over 400 years. Keyboard variations by William Byrd, Jan Pieterszoon Sweelinck, Girolamo Frescobaldi. I'm not doing anything new. Organists have been doing transcriptions of other music and also using popular songs for up to 400 years. So I'm doing something that's directly in that heritage. I'm actually not a rock or a jazz fan, so I'm coming at it from an outsider who saw this as an interesting compositional challenge. And although I've occasionally played show tunes or jazz tunes in something like a wedding because they were requested, my daughter is a fan of the alternative rock group My Chemical Romance. They broke up in 2013, and she asked me around about 2014 if I could arrange for organ her favorite song, which is Welcome to the Black Parade. And I did that, and she worked with me on that, and she helped me polish some of the melodies, some of the vocal lines, and so on. I made a YouTube video of it, we put it on there, and we had some fun, and I even played it for a couple of AGO chapter meetings. We then went on to work on some other My Chemical Romance songs, and two of them are on today's programs. And I was looking at this as a compositional challenge. You know, I'm studied composition on a doctoral level. I'm always looking for a new compositional challenge. And I'm also thinking, why are we limiting ourselves to transcriptions of orchestral music, classical orchestral music, when in fact Bach himself used popular songs in the Goldberg variations? So we had some fun and I started doing this, and I've also noticed that on my YouTube channel, I'm getting thousands or sometimes even 10,000s of views. So it's been fun to introduce my love of the pipe organ to people who aren't used to the pipe organ. So I'll play these three in a row. Mama was written by Ray Toro, the main songwriter of My Chemical Romance. The other band members challenged him to write an alternative rock song that was a polka. Yeah, those don't really go together, but that's what he did. You're going to get a polka. And it ends with a waltz. And it's about troubled relationship between a child and his mother. And in fact, some of the vocal was done by Liza Minnelli on the original recording by MCR. The second one, Cancer, is the song of a young man dying from cancer. It's a very straightforward song. I think the poignancy of it is highlighted by the fact that it's in a major key. And I wrote this something as a tribute to my own daughter because I contracted a lethal cancer 2 years ago. My life was spared, but the chorus of the song ends with the words, "The hardest part of this is leaving you." And that summarizes my relationship with my daughter exactly. And then the final one is Welcome to the Black Parade, the best known song of My Chemical Romance. Starting slowly, it uses the same chord progression as Pachelbel's Canon. You might even recognize it. It's the Black Parade is in fact about death itself, and it's about somebody dying and how people are saying they'll try to go on, we're weary, we're tired, but we'll carry on. So three by My Chemical Romance. And they all make good organ transcriptions, but my daughter is particularly impressed with Mama. She said, that just sounds like it was written for the organ.
Thank you.
Thank you. The levels of arranging that I'm doing here vary. The last three you heard, the two outer ones were heavily arranged. I wrote just about everything you heard. Cancer, more lightly arranged. Now, what I'm going to play for you now is a jazz standard by Fats Waller. And this one I'm doing differently from anything else on the program, because although I'm doing some arranging here, some of the decoration of the melodies are an improvisation by Fats Waller himself. So Mr. Waller is doing some of the arranging behind the scenes, you might say. Waller, just like Duke Ellington, would compose jazz standards, and then a lyricist would come along and fit words to them. Ain't Misbehavin' is one example, Honeysuckle Rose is another. I'm going to play this sort of like a scherzo, sort of lighthearted after all that people dying of the last three pieces. But I have a little story about this. I serve First Parish Congregation in Fitchburg, Massachusetts, which has congregational polity. And so each year on a Sunday after the church service, we have an annual meeting. And it's a business meeting. The congregation votes on the annual reports. Well, unfortunately, sometimes this meeting gets rather heated. Sometimes it's gotten actually quite ugly. And so what I've done for maybe the last 10 years or so, the Sunday of the annual meeting, for the postlude, I play Ain't Misbehavin'. Some years it works, and some years it doesn't. This is another jazz standard by Duke Ellington, the great composer in the history of jazz. And just like Mood Indigo and Ain't Misbehavin', lyrics were fitted to this after the composing of it. And I'm going to play this one pretty straightforwardly. I'm going to play the verse and the chorus, then I'll go back and play the beginning with a little bit of improvising, but not a whole lot. Duke Ellington didn't allow a lot of improvising in his band anyway. This is, again, one of the two pieces on the program that is an original organ composition. So every note here was composed for the organ. As you can see, it's written, again, after a pet of ours. This is in New York stride style, which is an early form of keyboard jazz. The two most famous developers of New York stride are James P. Johnson and Thomas Fats Waller. And I teach a history of jazz class at Fitchburg State. And listening to all this jazz, I kept thinking, why doesn't the organ have more of this, more of it written down, more of it in our history? And so just like with ragtime, I'm trying to do some early piano jazz styles. So this is in stride style. Every note is composed, and this was originally written for the organ. What I did, though, is I made this something of a tribute to James P. Johnson, who basically is the founder of the stride style. Now, you've all heard of the popular dance, the Charleston, which took the country by storm in the 20s. Well, the Charleston has a very characteristic rhythm in it, called a Charleston rhythm. And that rhythm comes from a popular song called Charleston, which was composed by James P. Johnson. So what I'm doing as a tribute to Mr. Johnson is the first two choruses of this use the chord progression from his famous stride piece, Carolina Shout. The middle section, which I'm going to play on the bottom keyboard, the choir, is in fact a Charleston. And the final segment is based on the chord progression of his stride number, You've Got to Be Modernistic. There are also a few little licks here and there that I lifted from Fats Waller. So although an original composition, it uses chord progressions of two jazz greats, one jazz great, and also, of course, a little bit of reference to another jazz great. Although I like many, many show tunes, so-called Tin Pan Alley songs, music from musical theater, that's already sort of the turf of the theater organist, so we largely have that covered. I'm aiming more towards classic jazz, classic rock, because the organ world doesn't have that covered quite as much. However, I do play some of them, and of course we've all been asked to play things like this at weddings and funerals. All of us have. Is this the most beautiful popular song ever written? I admire this, Over the Rainbow, because you have this text of longing and unfulfillment, but it's also in a major key, which causes a little bit of interesting spin on the whole thing. And you have these wide leaps in it. It's such a beautifully crafted song. My favorite trivia piece about this particular song is that in the movie The Wizard of Oz, the main character Dorothy sings this in a barnyard. And the producers at MGM were thinking of cutting the song out altogether because it was kind of unseemly. But cooler heads prevailed, and of course now it's, well, the most beautiful popular song of all time, maybe. I'm again going to use one of those orchestral organ tricks towards the end where I'll be playing the melody on the great manual and thumbing down to the choir manual.
Thank you.
jump. I've been thinking since the mid-1980s that this would make a really good organ arrangement, but I finally got the courage to try it only a few years ago, and courage was the right word. I've lost count of how many eighth notes there are on the pedal, but it does number in the hundreds. So I hope you appreciate that. I literally had to work myself up to that level. This is a very carefully done arrangement where I tried to get absolutely everything in it. The synthesizer part, the vocal part, the guitar solo, and even the band shouting jump. So I tried with everything I had to try to put everything in it. I hope you enjoy it. you like another one? This is another yearnful, longing song of loss that's in a major key. Paul McCartney and John Lennon yesterday. Thank you so much for the invitation.